Yeah, hello. Would like to welcome you to our weekly webinar today related to the IBKR Mobile App. And I want to present you a few things, how to use the IBKR Mobile App and what you can actually do. Also comparing to the client or web trader and the TWS platform. So if the sound is okay and you can see the PowerPoint presentation, you can use the chat function to let me know if everything is stable and visible for you. And then we would like to start in the next 2 minutes. Okay, great, thanks. Then yeah, the legal disclaimer that this is not investment advice or any trading recommendation. I think yeah, you might know all this from the beginning. My name is Christian Walter from TradeVola. Just a few basic facts about me, but I think the most important is coming now. This is the IBKR mobile app, and today they are like, we are not having the time to discuss each and everything, but I think the main facts to use the portfolio. Also, what is quite interesting, of course, is to see your account with all the margins, loans, or your equity, what is available for purchasing other assets. And the next topic where we also want to go over is monitor. How to create a watch list, and I think most important, how to create or how to change columns in your monitor, even in your portfolio, to see maybe some more information that what is shown as default. And last but not least, we want to also give a short overview about order and trades, where you can see all your orders. You can even access from here the account management to see all the information what you find in your account management, where you can add market data, change a few things, and even download your statements and reports. So I think comparing the mobile app to the TWS platform, it's easier. I would say it's not all functionalities available like you might know it from the TWS platform. But yeah, especially if you're not in front of your computer, it's a easy access to all your orders and trades and monitors. And even what is for me also very interesting, what is a little bit down of this menu, what I would also show you in the mobile app is the alert function. Especially if you are not at home and you just want to have a message when there's like a stock going below or under a certain price, it makes sense to set this as an alert so that you are able to just check your TWS or mobile app in this moment when something really important happened. Okay, then let's go to the mobile app. I hope you will see each and everything in a second. So here we go. As you should see now, the mobile application. And like I said in the beginning, there are like a lot of different settings what you can change here in the mobile app. I would like to start with the portfolio, where you can see everything what is related to your account. I think this is clear. This is a daily profit and loss. Your total unrealized profit and loss you always find here. Net liquidation value is also here available. And all your positions are displayed here. I think what is important for you in the beginning to change maybe some columns. And this is something what I want to present you because, oh, sorry. We should see it without, just a little bit slower. If you click on these three dots here on top of the mobile app, you can change actually all columns. Just go to manage columns because there are a few things what you normally don't see in the beginning. For me, very important is the total unrealized profit loss, because I think mainly or the basic default settings will only show you the daily profit and loss. I mean, it's more important to see the total unrealized profit and loss, and all this you can add here. Just go to add columns, and then you can check for all the columns which are available. It's quite a lot, and if you don't have enough space on your display, like you see, I can easily just go and see the total profit and loss at the end of this portfolio overview. So to change it, like I said, just go here to manage columns, and there are a few things even mentioned below. For me, like I said, the unrealized profit and loss is something very important, and this is exactly what is highlighted here. You find this under positions and P&L, and yeah, there are many, many more: average price, P&L percentage. I mean, the rest is up to you. Maybe there are some columns what are also important for you, other than last change in position size. But I think yeah, it's easy for you to check this on your own IBKR mobile app. I just want to go to the next important step. Current convert currency is, I think, mainly important for people who are trading on a cash account, because in the cash account you have a base currency. What yeah didn't Doesn't was not important that the base currency is also matching the same what you are holding in the cash position. But if your base currency, for example, is euro and you want to trade something in the US US dollar, you need to convert it before in the cash account. In the margin accounts, not needed. But I know in the TWS, it's a lot of people are struggling. Let's put it this way: if they want to change currency, in the mobile app, it's super easy. You don't even have to think about it, how to do it in which way. I just type the number here. Let's see. I want to convert euro and USD, and then I just type how many euros I want to convert. And then I see the amount in USD. What makes it super easy to convert currency? It's much better than, to be honest, in the TWS platform and in the client portal. I didn't find any settings how you can change it there. So I always recommend it to do it in the mobile app. This is for me most easiest way. But like I said, this is only important for cash accounts, or if you I know a few people, they also receive funds in a currency which they want to convert, and normally the bank is taking commissions or giving you not even the best price. So IB is or TradeStation Global is also a good platform to just change currencies, because you can do it much cheaper than with your normal bank account. So then we go to monitor. Like I said, what is for me an important information is your net liquidation value. Of course, you see it also on your portfolio itself, but also what is available in cash, what is holding in securities, maybe how much is your margin, what is left, and all these informations you found here under account, where you can check what is your current maintenance margin or how much margin did you already use. So all these information you find here with your buying power, for example, also very important. Maybe mainly for people who also like to do day trades. So you find this under funds. So for me, at the end of every trading session, the account section is something really important where I can check my balance, my margin, and my funds. And it's very easy, and I think a little bit more efficient than doing it on a client portal or on a TWS platform. So if there's anything what I'm going over a little bit too fast, just let me know. We are always able to answer your questions, what you can or where you can use the chat function in GoToMeeting, but we will also have a few minutes at the end of the presentation where we can still discuss a few questions what you might have. So this was account. Let's go to the next topic, what is so-called monitor, where you can include your own watch lists. I think there's some basic watch lists implemented. I think it's quite easy. You see this button, new watch list, where you just can create a new watch list. The watch list should also match exactly with your watch lists what you use in your TWS platform. So if you create a watch list over there, you should also have access here on the IBKR mobile app. And here's pretty much the same. I mean, to add a symbol, I think that's quite easy. If you know the symbol, just type it in and you will see the stock or the asset you selected in the watch list itself. And here's the same way what I told you earlier to change some columns, because as you see, we only have last change percentage and volume. I can also click on, wait a second, I just click on manage columns. And here it's exactly the same what I showed you earlier in portfolio. So if there's anything what you are missing here, for example, dividends, if you want to see dividend amount, the date, ex-dividend date, or even the dividend yield, we can just add this. And let's select a good dividend stock. For example, Verizon is normally, even Apple, okay. Dividend date is this is not the ex-dividend date, but you see the yield at the end. What is also very interesting. So for example, Verizon gives you a dividend per year of 4.2%. And the amount of dividend, you also see it's quarterly paid. So every quarter normally, Verizon will pay out 61 cent. So all this information can be added to your portfolio as well as your monitor. And I think it's quite convenient that it's also matching with what you're normally using in a TWS platform. So if you're not in front of your computer, you can access the same watch list like in your TWS platform as well. So these are the main facts for a monitor. Let's maybe add a few other symbols as well. General Motors and Teva Pharmaceuticals. Quite an interesting symbol, especially after the news this week. The stock went down a lot, and I think to finalize the monitor, like if you select any of these symbols, you will always see a short small chart, but on the right hand side you find the button more, and then if you click on more, you have really everything what is needed for the symbol. I mean, you can see a chart on a 2 hour basis, on a 1 day, 2 day, you can see select all the different durations here to see maybe also some more historical data, and then if we scroll a little bit below, we see the implied volatility, market capitalization, dividend as well. What we have in our like monitor columns included now, you will also see it in the detailed overview with all the news, analyst ratings. So mainly I think all important information for a stock or any asset what you need to include in your monitor. And just to show you two other things. If you want to trade it, you can easily trade it from watch list itself. You can see here, this is how normally I do it. This buy and sell button. As soon as you click on the buy button, you will see the order entry window on the mobile app version, where you can choose the limit price, time in force, I mean duration, everything what is needed. You can even access attached bracket order, means if you want to enter the market and set a stop and the limit order or target order as well, then everything is also available here on the mobile app. Yeah, it would be nice. I saw a few questions if we can stay on the topic for the presentation. I know there are a lot of other questions which might be not connected to the mobile app. I will try to answer this at the end, but so far, if there's something in between, I would suggest that you start with questions related to the IBKR mobile app. Otherwise, we will confuse maybe other people because the topic today is the mobile app itself. So yeah, for buy and sell, just use these buttons below. There's one option if you click on book, especially if someone is interested in level two data. Yeah, just a little, let's go back a little bit. There was a small issue. Yeah, the screen was frozen. Let's get back to the columns, maybe manage columns. What I showed you earlier is if you add some columns, you can select the same as with the portfolio in the beginning. And like I included this for symbols here, and if I click to more, you can see the chart with different time frames or different like historical data. You can even use your both fingers to make it a little bit bigger or zoom in and zoom out. And if you are interested in like having the market depth, the full market depth, if you applied for the data, you can see even the full book of this very zone stock, where you can also place your order just by clicking. Was a little bit fast clicking on the left side. If you want to buy this stock, you just need to select the quantity, and then you see buy limit, buy stop. So this is mainly, I think, for people who are trading like in this short duration day trading. Maybe is the book trader something what is quite interesting also here in the mobile app. So this is the book trader. I think options is also quite easy. If you add any symbol to your watch list, and let's go one step back, you click here on more, where you can see this detailed overview. You will find here on top all the things like book trader and options, what might be also interesting for the asset which you selected here. And because the screen was frozen, I just want to show you a few things what we can also see below the chart. What I mentioned earlier, everything what is important to see on a stock, for example, what is the volume average, what is the volume today, the dividend in percentage, all these informations are also coming below. Analyst ratings, if someone is interested in, you will also find here. So I think mainly all the important facts are in this detailed overview of your single asset, which you selected from the monitor. So yeah, I hope, just to make it short, that the first thing was shown on the screen, how to select or how to create a new watch list. I think this is also pretty simple. There are several watch lists already included, which you can also use. And like I told you in the beginning, normally the watch list should be also available on your TWS version as well. So what did we see? It was portfolio, how to convert currency, account, Hopefully, this was also shown on the screen with the margins, funds, and market value. What is very important, but I think this was still shown on the screen, so we can go to another quite interesting thing. What I forgot in the beginning is the IBOT type to trade. So if there's anything where you need an answer, there's I would say like a good solution of a FAQ file where you can find everything what is important. Just type your question here, and this IBOT normally will bring you all the answers. It's a little bit difficult maybe to find the right answer, but it's a really good overview about everything what is needed for the TWS or the IBKR mobile app. This might also help you to find some information what you might missed in the beginning. So then let's go to orders and trades. For the moment, we don't have any open orders, but I can even see the trades from yesterday. There was a trade on the S&P 500 ETF, what expired, and it normally should go back for the last, or it should show you the last 3 days with all your trades and open orders. So at the end of the day, I normally also check if there's any open order which I need to cancel or which I might need to change. Yeah, account management also interesting that you can just access the account management here from your IBKR mobile app as well. So this is also something what makes it a little bit more easy to work with the mobile app instead of using the TWS platform where you have the same options for accessing the account management. So notifications, I think this is something what might be clear for all of you as you get the notifications in your client portal in the same way. And TWS platform will also show it to you. I just want to show you the function of the scanner where you can create your new scan for every asset class. If you want to scan something for the US stocks, let's maybe start first with the already existing library of your scans because there you also find, if I'm not mistaken, some dividend list. The most common, of course, US movers, where you can see the biggest gainers and losers, which you can also easily add to one of your monitor. For example, here we see Transocean is symbol or stock from Switzerland, one of the biggest losers today, and I can add them to the whole list to my monitor. And if I want to have a symbol, one second, let's go back to the scanner. So here we had the library. It's already entered. Here, this was what I want to show you, the dividend. If I run this, you should have the information here. I mean, just make sure because in the US, it's quarterly paid dividends. And if you find something with a really, really high dividend, it can also be that the stock went just down a lot and that the percentage of the dividends so high because the value of the stock changed rapidly in the last months. But it's also a good watch list to see maybe some more interesting dividend symbols than what you normally find in newsletters or on different websites, for example. And add to monitor is same. Okay, save symbols. You can even save all the symbols from the scan today. I mean, in the dividends, there will be no change tomorrow. But like, of course, for the US movers, you will always have the biggest movers from the actual day. So if you want to have a look on these symbols from the previous day, it's I think a good idea to even save the symbols. Yeah, but you can also play around a little bit with the different apps or the different functions here in the IBKR mobile app. And if there's anything, any questions, just feel free to contact us, because I think normally it's easy to watch it, but at the end it's I would say always try and error to find the right settings or the right things what you might need for your trading setups in the IBKR mobile app. Very interesting is for me, or very important, is the alert function. So you see this same here on the left hand side with all the different tools. So let's just go to alerts and then find a symbol. We have the you have to go to the plus at the bottom to create a new alert. So, and then we just give it a name. Say trade roller. Then we start with the conditions. Yeah, what is might be also interesting, if you are trading on a margin, you can even create an alert when your margin's getting really low, especially for people who are using the margin. This might be interesting to have this information before IB might close some positions automatically. I mean, normally if you are if there's not left much margin left, you will get automatically a notification, but here in the conditions you can create this even a little bit earlier. I think the most common condition for an alert is price. And then you have to select the symbol for where you want to have this price alert. We can do, for instance, here Snapchat from New York Stock Exchange. And then let's say I want to have an alert for if it's going above $22.90. Yeah, this should be a last price. You can also include outside the regular sessions if this is interesting for you. If this is after hours coming above this $22.90. And what is also very important, that you can not only select one condition, I can add another condition. Let's say Snapchat and the S&P 500 ETF. Oh, yeah, it's not available for trading. Then we should choose the we can choose just any other stock. Let's stay on Apple. And we can actually do exactly the same for Apple. And then you just choose like end, or I clicked on end. So both condition must match before I get an alert. And at the end of the day, you just need to click here on create an alert. And then our alert will be shown here on the screen. And if you if you click on it, you can easily delete it or change it. The interesting thing, what I said in the beginning, is that this alert normally will come as a push-up message. So you don't have to check your application the whole time. You don't have to see what is Apple or Snapchat doing. It will just give you the alert, and then you can enter your trade. Here in the mobile app itself, you can't connect alerts to orders, because in the TWS, you might know it, there's a possibility to say if Snapchat and Apple is above this price, then I want to place a market order for Snapchat, for example. This is something what is missing here, what is not possible with the with the mobile app, but at least you don't have to check the price, and you will get a message when something really for you, something really important will happen. There's a question related to the scanner from library subscription for no, this oh sorry, this are even if you work on the late data, this is all available on the mobile app. So there's no special subscription or market data needed. Because on this account, I think I only have the option market data. So you can see even I can access all the watch lists or scanning tools with the late data on US markets. Just for your alerts, of course, if you don't have the real-time data, your alert might start a little bit later, 15 minutes later, because your prices are delayed. But there's no special subscription what you need for scanning. Just make sure you have the real-time data to really get the alert in the time where this stock also reaches the price what you set up there. Yeah, tax optimization was another thing what came up as a question. Something where I'm not really familiar with, but let's have a look. If we check, for example, no traded data available. But it's a good topic what I just write down, and I can produce a small video what you find on our YouTube channel. I hope I can have this ready by the next week, so I can just do some text. It's not what you think may or what you might think that's related to your whole account. It's more or less like you saw on single symbols, but the rest, like I said, you will find on our YouTube channel where I will make sure that I explain the text optimizer. So, alerts, scans, text optimizer, and account management. I think so far we covered the most important things on the IBKR mobile app. And let me check if there was any more question. Yeah, another important fact what I also need to mention is that you only have access to one of these tools. So, for example, I can't log into my TWS platform on the same time like the IBKR mobile app or the client portal. I mean, the client portal you can, but you can't place trades there when you're logged in your mobile app on the same time. If you need to have two separate logins, that's also not an issue. You can create as many logins as you want to have for one account. You just need to make sure, or like if you need on all different logins real-time data, that's the only thing what you need to pay separately. So, for example, if you have five different computers and you want to have it on all, or let's say three different computers on the same time running, same with your mobile app, you can apply for four different logins, and then you need to decide where you want to show the real-time data or where you might not need it. So this is I think also something what is quite easy to apply. If you're already existing TradeStation Global customer, just send us an email and we will set a separate login for you. And for anyone who's dealing directly with IB, you can also contact them and apply for a separate login. So what we might not cover in the beginning when I checked the portfolio, I mean the cash balance is below on a margin account. Like I said, it's pretty easy because you will not change your or you might not change your cash as you trade other currencies or in other currencies. but you normally have this overview here. And if there's a negative cash balance, the reason for this is on the margin account quite simple, because because if I open positions, all these positions are in US dollar, it will take the money and put a negative cash balance in this currency where I hold positions. As soon as I close them, the negative cash balance will be also closed, and only your profit and loss will always stay in the currency which you traded. So what does it mean in this account? For example, we started with a 10,000 euro. Now you can see it's 10,680 euros. So if I close all open positions at the end of the day, it means that there will be roughly or approximately 750, 800 US dollar as my profit. And then it's up to you. You can also transfer money in USD out of your account, or you can just change the money in the same way what we showed in the beginning with the very easy convert currency thing. So in this situation, I just need to do this is also something what is interesting, because it looks like because maybe I don't have any other cash balance, but I couldn't select in the currency I have, because of course I don't have any other open or positive cash balance. I couldn't select anything else than euros, but this should be also available on your IBKR mobile app. And the last thing, for people who are having more than one account, you can normally see your account number here on top. And if you're holding two, three accounts for different strategies, you can also have one login with all the different accounts. You just have to click on the account, and then you will see an overview of all different accounts which you can select from here. This is a good question. I can check the scanner later as well, but there's a question related to convert USD for USD stocks. Depends how long you want to hold the US stocks, but normally I would recommend to change the currency, because the negative USD cash balance also causes like interest. And if you hold like some of your cash in the currency which you want to trade in, then it's much better, because you avoid paying any interest in for having a negative cash balance in another currency. So especially on buy and hold, I highly recommend to change your currency in advance, because if you hold positions like for a really long time period, it depends also on the value, but the interest can go up. I mean, it's changing from time to time, as we all know, but there can be a few dollars what you pay in interest if you holding like negative cash balance. So this is something what you should really consider to do before you start trading in other currencies. Okay, then once again, let's check the scanner, but I don't have any subscriptions here. So as I didn't see anything coming up here, I mean, in the library, I could use each and everything. Maybe for own scans, instrument new stock. Okay, let's create a new scan for US stocks. Sorry, a second. Just let's check hot by option value. Yeah, this is something what I will also do a small video, but all the predefined scanners from the library should be accessible for you without any subscriptions for your own scans. Like I said at the beginning, for the text optimizer, I will also do a short video. What you will find on our YouTube channel then. Okay, yeah, so far these are the main facts for the IBKR mobile app. I think we already uploaded some small videos on our YouTube channel as well. So if you don't want to miss in the future any of the videos, feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And other than this, we discussed today portfolio, how to convert currency, very important, the monitor, and how to create your own watch lists. And if you want to delete one of them, you can just go to Manage tabs, and we can delete everything what we did earlier. Delete means just it's not showing on your monitor, and then we have our two watch lists here. What we can always change, and from there I think is the basic work where I start my trades, where I have the overview about all the information which are needed. Orders and trades, I think it's pretty easy. Account management, we did also a few videos. The account management, what you find here. Is almost the same what you or similar to what you have in your TWS platform, or which you can access from there. So you can change your market data, you can change your trading permission from here, even fund transfers and other statements you can access from here. So this is, I think, some really useful tool what you can use or what is implemented in the mobile app itself. So yeah, this is for the moment everything related to the IBKR mobile app. I would say thanks for your attention, and if there's anything else or if you need any additional information, I will give you just our contact information in a second, where you can always give us a call or send us an email, and all the other informations you will find on our website as well. As the IBKR mobile app is getting improved, I would say, or like more advanced step by step. I'm pretty sure in the future we will do some more videos and some more webinars for the IBKR mobile app. But if there's anything what is also interesting for you, like CFDs, I read a few things. We will do in the September a CFD webinar as well. It's not quite complicated, a few things to find, so I think it's useful to do some explanations on the CFD as well. But if there's something what is a little bit more complex, would be nice if you can send us just some short information in advance, so we can also prepare a few things for you. And as I already said, thank you for your attention, and I hope we can welcome you again in one of our next upcoming webinars. And last but not least, like I already said, feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you won't miss any of our upcoming videos. Thanks, and have a nice evening.